So now we will do cleaning of the crystals. Crystals have a tendency to absorb energy, be it negative or positive. So we have to clean the crystals before using this. The thoughts and emotions that a person is carrying are absorbed into the crystal. So previously we don't know who has been carrying the crystal, so we have to clean the crystal. So what we will do is that first clean the crystal before I use them. So it will cleanse the negative imprints from the earlier people. So once the crystal is clean and pure, we can use the methods to energize. So first let's talk about the easiest way. That is, the first one is soaking the crystals in salt water. As you can see, this is a bowl of water and I'm putting rock salt. So you can take this much rock salt and dissolve in the water. So with your hand you can just dissolve it in the water. This will integrate. You know, salt is a very good negative energy remover. In marriages and lot of traditions, salt is used to remove black magic effects and things like that. So we will take our crystals. So you can see this is a rose quartz, this is a tourmaline, this is an amethyst ball. So I will be putting them in the water and soak them overnight. So this has to be covered. The water is a little less, so it should be little above. The tip has also to be submerged. And now you will bathe these crystals for overnight, and you can keep this bowl into moonlight. You can put it in the full moon day night. That day they will absorb more of positive energy, and keep it overnight on a full moon day. So they will be like soaked overnight in full moon night and be cleansed, and then you take them out the next morning and you will put them under running water. You can see how beautiful they look after being soaked in the water. They have a shine. So you can take them out and have them run over normal tap water so that they become shining and beautiful, and leave them to get soaked. They get dried, so they will dry. Leave them on the bed or a nice towel, clean towel. And now you can also bathe your crystals in sunlight, in early sunlight. You can put them in early sunlight between 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. in summers. And you can just clean them by drawing symbols in your hand. So let's cleanse them by using the first symbol. So if I don't have time to soak them overnight, I can cleanse this ball by drawing the first symbol on this crystal. So when I draw this symbol, this gets cleansed. But however, it will be better if we can soak it overnight in rock salt. But all the crystals cannot be soaked in water, so don't worry. Quartz, amethyst, carnelian, we can put them in salt water easily. So by drawing the symbol and holding it and saying the affirmation, clean this crystal from all kind of negativities. My crystal is getting cleansed. So hold it for 3 to 5 minutes in your hand. And you can also invoke light invocation and say, I invoke the light of good within. I'm clear and perfect channel. Light is my guide. And this is getting cleansed, this is getting cleansed, this is getting cleansed. My crystal is getting clean and clean and clean. So affirmation will help in cleansing. Symbol first in Reiki will help in cleansing. Putting it in the sunlight, in the running water, or soaking in the full moon the whole night. So I prefer soaking in full moon night the whole night. Sometimes some crystals like pyrite cannot be soaked in water. So you can put it in moonlight or early sunlight to activate the crystal. So now you have cleansed the crystal completely. They are ready to be charged for your purpose. You will be programming them. So in the next video, we will talk about programming the crystal. And then we will see how you program and how to use the crystals. Thank you.